Okay, so there's a couple more elements that have been added to the source code. It's all on GitHub in the most recent versions. So now there's the injector as well. We've already had the viewing terminal. So there's the core server running the cellular automation universe. And then you had the viewing terminal that was its thin terminal system. So all you need is a web browser. You can make anything on your network turns into your viewing terminal, which also has some filters and whatnot. And now there's the injector. The injector code, what it does is it's a separate piece of code that runs on another SBC or other system, and it connects to a webcam. It takes the webcam, does a little bit of very simple processing on it, and then it injects that data over into the server. So what you've got is a camera fed into the 2-bit universe, and the 2-bit universe running and feeding its stream into the viewing terminal. So what this allows us to do in total is we've got a camera being fed in through an injector, being pre-filtered to be in a somewhat, compatible data format. This is the best way to say it for now. Black and white pixels is the easiest way to integrate the data for now. Of course, you could integrate more complex data, but keeping it simple for now. And then there's a universe running, and it's producing a constant feed of output frames. And these output frames are actually fetched, so it doesn't. The server's not constantly just spewing data. It's the client has to fetch each frame, which, in the long run, might be something that I'll look at switching away from. But for now, I prefer it that way. I don't want to have some threads that are just feeding out data if it's not being used. So instead, every frame must be requested for now. And then the idea would be that that could even then be put through another filter, throw another SBC in there. So there's another SBC that's fetching a feed from the universe, and then it could be converting that into anything, whether it be a video feed or a feed of data that can be fed into like a terminal or Unity or Unreal or anything like that. Basically, so the camera is running through, the camera feed is being serial processed through a whole bunch of separate processes before it ends up at that final game environment or wherever, or video environment or wherever it's going to be. Now, one of the key points here is definitely that when writing into the universe, we are only writing the black pixels in and not overwriting whatever's in the white pixel. We don't force the universe to be a perfect match of what we were feeding in. Otherwise, it would just be a predictable feed of... The feed would be a progression of each frame coming from the camera, and the progression would happen until it was completely overwritten. Now what we have is the blacks are overwriting and the whites are staying whatever they previously were. So when you inject your data, you're not just going to have the proper progression of whatever that data would be. You're also going to have that influenced by the entire area surrounding it and the history of that area, basically. So there's now an opportunity for events from the past to compound and affect the future in various ways, etc., etc. You've got more of a realistic universal interaction. You're injecting the data, but you've still got some residual chain effects left over, potentially from very long ago. And finally, here's a bunch of screen captures of me running the system. I've accelerated the video so I could fit more examples in here without making it way too long, but you get the idea. Also, I expect to speed the system up significantly. This is running on some really crappy hardware right now, so all it needs is some small upgrades, and these speeds are easily achievable. But I'm more focused on resolution. I want to get that resolution way up there before I worry about accelerating the speed of the system, actually. Well, not that it's just an easy trade-off.